Hi, I'm Joey Lovato. I'm the multimedia editor here at the Nevada Independent, and I am joined today by the Deputy Secretary of State for Elections, Wayne Thorley. How's it going, Wayne?
Good. How are you doing, Joey?
Good. And you're here to talk to me today about a website that the state has created to help signature cures for mail-in ballots. We've got mail-in ballots here for this coming election. Can you kind of explain to me what signature curing is?
Sure. When a voter returns their mail ballot, their ballot return envelope must be signed. If the ballot return envelope is not signed, or if the signature on their ballot return envelope does not match the signature we have on file for the voter, their ballot will not be counted until it goes through what's called the signature cure process. And all that means is it's an opportunity that the voter has to either add a signature when they had forgotten to, or correct the signature error that was on their ballot.
All right. So yeah, how will a voter be notified if they need to cure their signature on their ballot?
Within 48 hours of the county becoming aware that the voter needs a signature cure, they will be sent a letter to the address that we have on file for the voter, and the letter will give them a few options about how to cure their signature. One of the options will be to engage in the electronic signature cure process. That they'll also be given a unique PIN number that allows them to go through electronic signature cure.
So they'll get this PIN number, and there's two ways that they can respond, right? They could either just send it in by mail, or that they can do this digital one, which is the new website that the state has developed. Can you kind of explain to me what the website is, how it works, how voters can access it?
Sure. So if the voter wants to go through the electronic signature cure process, they will text the word Nevada to the number 2Vote, which is 28683. Once they do that, they'll get a text message back with a link to the website. They'll click on the link to the website. The website will ask them to enter the unique PIN number that comes on the letter that they received from the county. Then it'll ask them if they voted their ballot for the 2020 primary election or not. Then they'll sign an affidavit, and all of this is done on their phone. They'll sign their name. They'll take a picture of their ID. Allowable ID includes driver's license or ID card from the Nevada DMV. But you could also use other forms of ID, such as a passport, a military ID, even employee ID card that you have from your work, or a student ID card from your school, pilot's license, anything like that will work. You'll take a picture of that. And then just hit submit, and all that is packaged into a secure file that is sent to us at the state office. Your ballot will be counted, and that's all you need to do. It takes only a couple of minutes.
So when do these signature cures need to be done by?
Voters have until 5 p.m. On June 16th to return their signature cure information. That's 7 days after the election. However, we encourage voters not to wait that long. As soon as you receive the signature cure letter from your county, go ahead and start acting on that immediately so that there's no delays in processing your ballot, and we make sure that your ballot counts.
And so for those that don't want to do the digital signature process, they can still just mail in a letter? How does that work?
Correct. The letter that the voter received from the county informing them that they need to cure their signature will also include a paper affidavit that they can sign that they could return by mail, by fax, by email. They can take a picture of their ID or make a photocopy of their ID and return it with that document. And that's kind of the old school analog process.
All right. Great, Wayne. Well, thank you so much for chatting with us.
Not a problem. Thanks for having me.